good in the gas brothers. I'm sure that heels are in line with each other.
Brothers, if you just move forward.
Move forward, please.
Yeah, that's it.
You're right, it's killing my brothers. Look left and right to the rows and make sure that you're all in line. So that your heels are above in front of me, like the case here. So the heels are in front of the other line. As previously mentioned, the first rak'ah will be 7 takbirs after takbirat al-ihram, including takbirat al-ihram, and in the second rak'ah will be 5 takbirs after takbirat al-intiqal, after we've made our way up. 5 additional takbirs. And then the khutbah is after the salah. And listening to the khutbah is a sunnah. And if someone is in a rush, unable to listen to the khutbah, they don't have to attend it and they can leave. However, any congratulating or talking or things like that should be delayed until after the end of the khutbah, even in night time. Still continue. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar.
Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Maliki Yawmiddin. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى وليسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى الله سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. Allahu Akbar. 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 Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Malik Yawm al-Din, Iyaka na'budu wa Iyaka nasta'in, Ihdina as-sirata al-mustaqim, Sirata al-lazina an'amta alayhim, Ghayri al-maghdubi alayhim, والضحى والليل إذا سجى ما ودعك ربك وما قلى وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى ولسوف يعطيك ربك فترضى ألم يجدك يتيما فآوى ووجدك ضالا فهدى ووجدك عائلا فأما اليتيم فلا تقهر وأما السائل فلا تنهر وأما بنعمة ربك فحدث. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. ولله الحمد. الله أكبر كبيرا. الحمد لله كثيرا. سبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد. Brothers and sisters, In these few days, we witness one of the great symbols of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the greatest rituals and symbols and sha'a'ir of Allah ta'ala. ذَلِكَ وَمَنْ يُعَظِّمْ شَعَائِرَ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّهَا مِنْ تَقْوَى الْقُلُوبِ. And whoever honors the symbols of Allah, that's a sign of taqwa in the hearts. The symbols of Allah are things like the salah in jama'ah, are things like the adhan, are things like the uhiyah, hajj, fasting, zakat. These apparent, open, visible features of Islam, things that you define Islam by. Whoever honors these, that's a sign of taqwa, Allah Ta'ala tells us in Surah Al-Hajj. And the most beloved thing on this day and the next few days for Allah Ta'ala is the sacrifice, the uhiyah. And this uhiyah is one of the greatest symbols of the oneness of Allah and Tawheed in the religion of Islam. And we truly understand that when we understand the nature of the Arabs before Islam and how sacrifice to the idols was a major part of their faith. And so Islam abolished the idolatry that existed and abolished the shirk that existed by making the sacrifice to Allah Ta'ala alone one of the most important symbols and rites in Islam. And that's why Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala commands His Prophet and says, فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَنْحَرْ. And pray to your Lord alone and وَنْحَرْ means sacrifice, slaughter. Slaughter to your Lord alone. قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ لَا شَرِكَ لَهُ. Say, my life and death. قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي. Say, my salah and my slaughter, my sacrifice, and my life and my death is for Allah alone. لَا شَرِكَ لَهُ. Without any partners. And Allah Ta'ala says, tells us in Surah Hajj, it's not its blood or meat that will reach Allah. When we're sacrificing for Allah Ta'ala, it's not that we're gifting meat to Allah Ta'ala, or that Allah is going to benefit from the blood that's shed during sacrifice. وَلَكِنْ يَنَالُهُ التَّقْوَى مِنْكُمْ. But it's taqwa, it's your awareness of Allah, it's your firm belief in the oneness of Allah that reaches Him. إِلَيْهِ يَصْعَدُ الْكَلِمُ الطَّيِّبُ. To Allah rises good words and good speech. So our taqwa rises up to Allah. Our tawheed and oneness to Allah rises up to Allah. And that's what benefits us in this dunya and in the akhirah. أَقُولُ مَا تَسْمَعُونَ وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده أما بعد. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explicitly tells us in Surah Al-Hajj, وَالْبُدْنَ جَعَلْنَاهَا لَكُمْ مِنْ شَعَائِرِ اللَّهِ. And the budn, the camels. And that includes also anything else that we slaughter, camels, sheep, cows. مِنْ شَعَائِرِ اللَّهِ. It's from the symbols of Allah. لَكُمْ فِيهَا خَيْرٍ. There's good in it for you. فَذْكُرُوا اسْمَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهَا صَوَافٍ. So mention Allah's name upon it. Then Allah Ta'ala says, فَإِذَا وَجَبَتْ جُنُوبَهَا فَكُلُوا مِنْهَا وَأَطْعِمُوا الْقَانِعَ وَالْمُعْتَرَ. So eat from it, eat from the sacrifice, and give to the poor, give to the one who asks, and give to others as well. And therefore, this shows us the importance of making the Udhiyah a symbol. It's already one of Allah's symbols in Islam. But then we still have a part to play in ensuring that that symbol is felt amongst ourselves, our families, our children, communities. If it's easy for going yourself to slaughter, brilliant. If that's not facilitated, then the meat at least is brought home, and children are taught about this. Children are taught that this is the sunnah of our father Ibrahim alayhi salam, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us. Children are taught that this is one of the symbols of worshipping Allah alone, and that this is one of the distinct features of the message of the Prophet's Islam, and also giving some of it to the poor, and giving some of it to friends and family, and keeping some of it for that purpose. And so therefore we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to fill our hearts with Iman and Tawheed in this life, and to make us followers of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in every aspect of our life, and for this Tawheed and this Iman to save us in the Akhirah. Allahumma salli wa sallam wa barik ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. والحمد لله رب العالمين والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Pick up your sweets on the way out, please. Jazakumullah khairan. Tahabbab la minna minkum.